Okay, right. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh and very good morning to everyone. Yeah, today we're going to have a class. Yeah, our class today will be on chapter 3. So in chapter 3 is on heterogeneous reactions if internal diffusion control the reaction. Okay, so let me present to you my slide. Yeah, just go straight away to
Nampak.
You have to respond. Okay, you have to respond because I cannot see the slide yang tu, eh? Okay.
Nampak, doktor.
Sekejap ada yang masuk tu. Ya, yeah? Sekejap, eh. That's why. Kalau boleh nak minta semua orang masuk awal, ya. Yeah? Lagi tak ada, ya. Eh? Okay. So, on our slide, ya. Yeah? So our slide, so chemical reaction engineering 2, so chapter 3, so for chapter 3 is diffusion on reaction in a porous catalyst. So you have to revise back what you have learned before that. It's just a continuity from chapter 2. Eh? Chapter 1, 2, 3, dia relate. So in chapter 3, so these are the topics that we're going to cover on a diffusion reaction in spherical catalyst pellet. Internal effectiveness factor, phosphate kinetics, mass transfer and reaction in a PET bed, and some determinations on limiting situation on the reaction data. So based on the outcome of the chapter 3, it means these are the skills that you need to master at the end of this course. Sorry. You should be able to describe diffusion and reaction in a porous catalyst. You should be able to define the Thiele modulus and the effectiveness factor and describe the region of the reaction limitation and internal diffusion limitations and conditions. So out of all these things, so I try to cover objective number 1 and number 2 today. Yeah. So we try to do next week yang number 3 ni. Right? Okay. Okay, so you have to revise back what you have learned in previous chapter. So we got 7 steps, yeah, ingat 7 steps, yeah, 7 step of the reaction mechanism, ingat, yeah, bulk in, pour in, diffusion, surface reaction, absorption, surface reaction, desorption, pour out, bulk out, eh, I repeat, bulk in, pour in, absorption, surface reaction, desorption, pour out, bulk out. So step number 3, 4 and 5 covered in chapter 1. Step number 1 and number 7, external diffusion, you study in chapter 2. So in this chapter 2, you already know how to find your KC. And the last one is, then today we're going to cover on step number 2 and number 6, internal diffusion. Yeah, so internal diffusion is how the molecule going to transfer from inside the catalyst. Yeah, inside the catalyst. So this is the catalyst surface. So inside the catalyst surface, this is the bulk on the catalyst surface, and then need to go to inside the pore, and this is where the active site occur. The reaction occur on in the pore. So the molecule go inside the pore and do the reaction. After that, it move out. So the internal diffusion is the one who control the reaction. Means the movement inside the pore to the active site is the one that control the reaction because it taken the longest time. Yeah. Okay. So that is what you're gonna cover in chapter 3. Right. So we'll see who's coming in, yeah. Okay. All right. So from there. Okay, so from there, so we need to go straight away to, okay, yeah. So this one we have done, eh? This one we also done. So number 2 and number 6, eh? Catalytic mechanism number 2 and number 6. Yeah. Okay. how the diffusion occurred. So let's say the bulb in go on the surface of the catheter and there's a lot of pore, so they need to go inside the pore. So that one is the one who control the reaction. So we still consider the molar flux, WA. However, there's no bulk flow. If there's no bulk flow, then we need to have a DE. In last week, we used DAB, isn't it? Because it's in a bulk. Now we have a DE, effective diffusivity. How effective it is to diffuse, to go inside the pore. So remember, it still depends, your DE, it still depends on your DAB. DAB, this is your porosity. And this is your constriction factor, your constriction factor divided by totosity. This totosity would be the distance of the two points and the actual over the shortest distance. So if you have a very dilute condition, then you have to use a Knudsen diffusivity. Typically, if you do not know what is your DE, if we give you DAB, then you can find DAB by using this equation, table. DAB we also give you, because it's a constant, and then how it depends on the temperature, it depends on the pressure, remember all the chapters in table 11 something tu kan, so or else we'll give you the DE, okay, you can find the DE as well, either ni, so let me see if there any friends. More important thing is I just go straight away. If you have this slide, you may see this slide and understand it. And then, or else, what I want you to know is, we want to have a DC. Why DC is important? DC, but DE, diffusivity. Why is it important? Because this DE is related to, we need to find the diffusivity, pillar modulus, sorry. Ni pening. Yeah, you don't have to go to this one. This one is very pening. Yeah, I don't want you to get through of it. What I want you to know is your tiller modulus here. Tiller modulus. Ni it's just like porosity. However, dia ada dia punya ni. Very simple. Sekejap, I make it simple. Untuk hari ni, what I want you to know, first of all, you need to know this one, ada kuasa, and here. So, this is tiller modulus, tiller modulus, saya buat TM je lah, senang. Okay, so after this tiller modulus, then you need to know your effectiveness factor. This effectiveness factor, then from this effectiveness factor, then you need to find this omega. Nampak macam ni, okay. This is your tiller modulus, this is your effectiveness factor, okay. And this is would be your effect ratio, if I'm not mistaken, omega. That would be the omega. So today, what I want you to know, your Tiller modulus. Why we need the Tiller modulus? From the Tiller modulus, then we would know which one control the reaction. Is it internal diffusion control, or is it external diffusion control, or is it a surface reaction control? So on today, I want you to understand on how to calculate the Tiller modulus. From Tiller modulus, the effectiveness factor, then to omega. Okay, so from this, this Tiller modulus, this Tiller modulus, how to do that? The modulus is from this one, this Tiller modulus is, you need to calculate the Tiller modulus when this Tiller modulus is equals to KN R squared CAS N over D DE. Tiller modulus, this is your Tiller modulus, KN R squared CAS DE over this one or this thing. So this Tiller modulus, how you going to calculate? This is your specific reaction rate. Your K would be your specific reaction rate. This one. K is specific reaction rate, specific reaction rate, Your K will be your specific. This is your radius for your R. And CAS will be concentration on the cathode surface. Your N is your order. N is your order of your reaction. Order. If it is the first order, then CAS is V1 minus 1 V0. So NKR over DE. If it is the second order, then 2 minus 1, then CAS will get the value. And your DE. DE we already give you. We give you the DE. Example. So N squared will be your Euler modulus. This is this one is your Euler modulus. N. Let's say it is a first order, then you will have something 1. It's just like porosity, but they have a right order at the bottom here. This is your order. Okay. So how to calculate this one? It based on this equation. Okay, look at your book. Okay, class, look at your book. This page. Nampak tak? Nampak 30?
Nampak.
Okay. So, that page, you will see this figure kan? Ada figure, 12.5. This figure 12.5. So, from that figure, this figure, bila in this chapter, you need to know the shape of the catalyst. The shape of the catalyst is very important. So dalam figure ni, this one, they have a zero order, first order, second order, provided this one is for spear shape. Okay? Nampak tak ni? First order, second order. You jangan baca sangat pada graph dia sebab bila graph dia ni, it just respond based on qualitative. It's just a qualitative shape. So in order for you to calculate, please use this equation. Please use this equation. First on, besarkan sikit tak nampak. Okay, do not use this data to read. Katalah you kata Euler modulus you 2 dan effectiveness 0 order, you pun ambil macam ni. Jangan buat gitu Because this one is quantitative, so means that it's just like a rough, rough idea. We don't know whether this one, I think is in a log form, But this is not start from zero, So you have to be careful with this one. So in order to do that, the best thing is you need to use this equation, Zero order, first order, provided this one is for first, for spear, spear shape. For example, let's say your Euler modulus for zero order. So this is your equation. For first order, this is your equation. For second order, this is your equation for sphere. However, if you have other shape, but it is in the first order. So you need to use this equation. This one other shape, tapi first order. Tapi mesti dia first order. First order. This is only first order but different shape. However, you got this one. This is spear for first order. Also got spear for first order. If you want to use, you can use either one. You can use either one. But during the test, please simplify, please indicate which one that you want to use. If you want to use this one, please indicate. This one will be your first order. Ada masalah tak? You okay with that?
Okay, doctor.
Faham eh? Okay, turn to the next page. This is for first order. First order. Okay, go to page 831. 831. This page 831. This is also another Euler modulus, how to calculate if it is not the shape that's been mentioned just now. It's not in sphere. And then it is not the others. For example, let's say you will have a cylinder at zero order. So, cylinder zero order. So, which shape, which one we can use? Ada tak? Ada tak? Tak ada kan? Cylinder zero order. So which equation that we need to refer to? Tak ada. So if tak ada, then the best thing is you need to use equation page 831, equation 1220. Use this equation. regardless what order you can use this one, regardless what shape you can use this one. I mean, like if it's not the shape, it's not been mentioned as in figure 12, 5, then you can use this equation. Boleh tak?
Boleh.
Make sure, okay, make sure your Thielen modulus if effective is dimensionless. It is dimensionless. Make sure the unit can be cross each other. Yeah. So, okay.
Yeah.
Alright. So, right. Okay, sampai sini okay eh? We got another one, okay? That is Thielen's modulus eh. Ingat tak tadi kan saya kata? The first one is you need to calculate your Thielen modulus eh. After you calculate your Thielen modulus, then you calculate your effectiveness factor. Then, after effectiveness factor, then you need to calculate your omega. Yeah. So, your Thielen modulus satu calculate is page 830 and 831. Yeah. So, you masukkan je dalam ni. Yeah. Okay, satu lagi, before we go to effectiveness factor, ingat nampak tak ni? Kan, dia ada K prime. Last week pun I also tell you about this thing. K double prime. Eh? This one based on the surface section. If you want to change to K prime, then you need to multiply with SA, surface reaction. Ni multiply ya. Eh? If this one need to go to this one, then go to K specific K, then you have to multiply with the density. Eh? If you want to go to this way, then you have to divide. Eh? This one darab. Eh? Darab. Divide, terbalik. Yeah. You can go to either way. Yeah. So, yang sini, nampak tak ni? Ni K double prime. Yeah, yang ni K double prime. This is SA. This is rho dan city. Nampak tak? Maksudnya dia akan keluar daripada K double prime, multiply with SA, multiply with the density, then you will get the K kat sini. Nampak tak? So, when you got this equation, make sure all these numbers, all this unit can be crossed. Eh? Because Thielen modulus are that. Thielen modulus is dimensionless. Eh? There's no unit. Eh? So make sure kalau kg, kg can cross each other. Eh? Kalau tak nanti masalah nanti. Yeah? Okay? So this is your Thielen modulus. Eh? Thielen modulus. Make sure. Lepas Thielen modulus, because when you get your Thielen modulus, you can calculate the effectiveness factor. How to calculate effectiveness? Okay, this is another graph of effectiveness factor. Yeah, please do not read from the graph. Yeah, because this is also quantitative graph where it just plot based on this one. But we don't know the scale here. That's why we unable to identify what's the value. Yeah, because this one also big one. Yeah, the best thing is to calculate your Thielen modulus is by using the effectiveness factor. And by using the equation. You may use equation 1235. Yeah, effectiveness factor here. Yeah. This one and the 2 divided by n order times 10 and then you need to calculate your Thielen modulus. That's why your Thielen modulus is needed. You need to calculate Thielen modulus then your effectiveness factor. These two things is needed. When you calculate your Thielen modulus, you calculate effectiveness factor, then you can verify either surface reaction control or internal reaction control or external diffusion reaction control. Eh? So that's why you need to calculate your Thielen modulus then from Thielen modulus then you calculate your effectiveness factor. Boleh eh sampai sini? Clear eh?
Clear, Doktor. Clear.
Clear eh? Okay, next. Turn to page 829. Okay, 829. Yeah? Okay, 829. In page 829, look at this page. Look at this equation. This equation n equals to 3 Thielen modulus cot Thielen modulus. This is how to calculate your effectiveness factor. Your Thielen modulus is you need to calculate based on page 830, right? Just now, based on that shape, based on the K value and everything. Then you got your Thielen modulus. So this equation 8229, you only can apply if it is in sphere shape. Other than that, you need to use equation 831. Faham eh? So this Thielen modulus is only calculated when it is a sphere And this is only applied, ya. Lepas tu, kalau if the value, if you look at here, kat tepi ni. This is only applied if your Euler modulus on the first order, this is a first order, nampak tak first order? First order and sphere, nampak tak sini? There's a four sphere reaction palette, Okay, so this one is only applied if your Euler modulus should be less than 2, should be less than 2, then you have to use this one. If it is more than 2, then you have to calculate your your effectiveness factor by using this equation. If it is more, your Euler modulus is more than 20, then you have to use this equation. Faham eh? This
faham.
Is only for, okay, good. This is only for the first order. First order sebab dia ada N1 bawah ni. Bawah 1 ni adalah order dia. Alright? Clear eh? Any question?
Doctor, for the equation 12.32, that's mean between 2 at the Euler's modulus between 2 and 20, we use 12.32, is it?
No. If this one, 12.32, only can apply if your Euler modulus less than 2.
Okay, doctor, thank you.
If other than that, you have to use this equation. Okay, this is only for first order.
Okay, doctor, thank you.
All right, good. Sampai sini, okay. Any question?
Okay, doctor.
Right. So as an exercise, what I want you to do is turn to page. Kita buat exercise dulu eh. Okay. Okay, turn to page 845. Ada tak? Simple je ni eh. 845 ada? Dapat? What I want you to do is calculate the Euler modulus and effectiveness factor. Boleh? You calculate that thing. While I get you another example. And then berapa kita buat another exercise. Okay? You go back to where, You go to page CWP, you need to calculate your CWP, turn to page, tadi berapa? CWP 839, 839, you need to go to 839. 839, equation 1260, 1261. This is CWP equation. You can use, because you have calculated your effectiveness factor and you can calculate your Euler modulus. So from that one, you can get your CWP. You can use either this equation or this equation. Boleh plug in back, sebab tak ada kena rho C here, rho C is a catalyst density, Okay, and then you can get the CWP. If your CWP is less than 1, means it is no diffusion limitation, means it might be controlled by surface reaction. However, if it is more than 1, then it is controlled by internal diffusion limitation. Okay, so after you calculate the CWP, this one, you can know this is controlled by internal diffusion. However, if it's less than 1, then it's no diffusion. But if it is, but we don't know whether it is external diffusion. What about external diffusion? Does it control or not? So in this case, you need to get the equation in page 84. Ms. Katrina, you go to page 841, 841, go to equation 1262. So this 1262 is Mears criterion external diffusion. This one to verify either external diffusion control or not. If in this case, then you need to identify, use this equation. You got rho A, rho B. This is got rho B, rho density. And you got R, you got N, and KC, CA, AB. In KC means because if it's KC, means we want to verify your external diffusion. If that is the case, if it is less than 0.15, means it is no external diffusion. But if it is more than 0.15, then you verify it is a external diffusion. Clear? You jangan hafal satu je. If it is less than 0.5, means it is no external mass transfer. Itu saja. Okay, MIAS for external diffusion. CWP is for internal diffusion. Clear?
Clear, Dr.
Okay, what I simplified it in a page, yeah, just now. Yeah, this is the page that I want to show it to you, eh? Okay, do you see this page? Nampak tak page ni? Nampak this figure, right?
Nampak.
Okay, this figure, ingat tak? We okay, good. We compare KR versus KC. Ingat tak? Last chapter 2. Because we want to verify either surface reaction or mass transfer control. Ingat tak? Ingat kan? External diffusion kan? If it is KR versus KC, if your KR is bigger than KC, kan? Bigger ke smaller? If your KC is smaller, so ini terbalik ni. Sorry, terbalik eh. Terbalik. This one terbalik. Yeah? This one terbalik, sorry. Betulkan balik eh. If KR is smaller than, if KR is bigger than KC, betul. If KR is bigger than KC, means what? If it is no, means your KR is smaller, that is controlled by surface reaction. Nampak tak? Sampai sini okay? Ni KR, dia punya justification, KR bigger than KC. If it is no, means it is surface reaction. If your KR is bigger than KC, then you need to do your CWP. If your CWP is bigger than 1, if it is yes, then it is internal diffusion. If it is no, then you need to calculate your MIAS criterion. Yeah? If your MIAS criterion, if it is no, then it is internal diffusion. Tapi, bila you dekat sini, bila dia betul juga, bila dia CWP is internal diffusion, eh, you calculate juga. Kadang sini yes, you kena calculate juga MIAS to identify. Kadang-kadang it can be both of them, internal dengan external sekali. Faham eh? So you need to calculate these two. What if your CWP is more than 1 and your MIAS is also less than 0.15? What happen? Let's say this one is yes. This one is also yes. This one is also no. Yes, no. Means it can be both. Eh? It can be both. So this one kena be careful sikit. Yeah? So, or in other way, yeah? Or macam ni pun kita boleh buat juga. Eh? Kalau MIAS versus ni, then it is controlled by surface reaction. If it is less, your KCAC is less than KR, it is external control. Confirm. Okay? If it is, then you compare your CWP, it is more than 1, it is not controlled by surface reaction, but it might control by internal diffusion. Okay, so you need to calculate your MIAS criterion. If it is less than 0.15, then it is not controlled by surface reaction, but it might be controlled by internal dia control. Eh, internal yang control. Okay, if it is less than A. If it is less, MIAS external does not control. So what if you have more than 1, this one is less than 1, and don't let this one dah kita tahu yang ni, ya. Yeah? So, sampai sini okay, ya? Eh? So, dari sini you boleh tahu dah. You boleh verify siapa ada internal diffusion or surface reaction or external diffusion control by using this equation. Boleh tak?
Boleh.
Okay. For example, let's say in your exercise, ya, yeah, in your exercise, sorry. In your exercise, nampak tak this equation? This is an example of final year question. Eh? Final exam. For example, say, a first order heterogeneous irreversible reaction is taking place within a spherical catalyst pellet with diameter of 0.15. The reaction is performed in a packed bed reactor and a diameter of 60 centimeter. So that is a reactor's diameter. Okay. which is working at steady state. The catalyst density is 2.3 gram per centimeter cube, and the bed porosity is 0.28. The gas phase diffusivity and effectiveness factor is this value. If gas phase diffusivity means this value is your DAB, this value is your DE. The kinetic viscosity is this value, and the volumetric flow rate of the reactor is 50,000 centimeter cube per second, and the reaction rate constant is this one. This is your K. Okay. The inlet concentration A of the reactor is 8.5 times 10 power negative 2 mole per centimeter cube. Assume isothermal operation and pressure drop across the reactor is negligible. Okay, evaluate whether the reaction is limited by mass transfer or surface reaction. If you got this one, so what will you do? What will you do?
Buat yang tadi, Doktor, buat verification.
Yes. This is what you need to do. First, you need to calculate your utility modulus. Then you need to calculate your effectiveness factor. Then you can calculate your CW, P and your MIAS criteria to identify either mass transfer control or not. Faham? Sebab why we need to verify it first? When you verify, then I've told you last time, if feed is controlled by mass transfer, then you have to use KC. Ingat tak? KCSC to design your reactor. If it is controlled by surface reaction, then you have to use KR to design your reactor. But if it is controlled by internal diffusion, then you have to use omega to calculate dia punya ni, calculation dia. Faham? That's why you need to verify it first. Right? Let's say from this one, then you identify it is controlled by internal diffusion, then your catalyst weight will be different. You nak buat sampai catalyst calculation ke? Sampai sini okay tak? Chapter 3 ni tak banyak sangat. But it's supposed to be okay. Sama juga dengan your example, this is your exercise in your book, in your kalam, exercise in your kalam. I already combine all this equation for you to do, for you to do as an exercise, okay? This one dia dah kata dah, look at this one. A first order irreversible reaction is performed in a fixed bed reactor of porous alumina with particle size of 0.15. Pure enter A reactor superficial blah 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 kan, assume isothermal reaction and pressure drop across the reactor is negligible. The void of the packed bed means there is a porosity. You said void mean porosity, under this condition the reaction severely affected by internal diffusion. Nampak tak? Kalau dia dah mention severely affected by internal diffusion, then you need to design reactor based on internal diffusion. Okay, bila ada internal diffusion, you all nampak my slide? Nampak tak? You see my slide, Nampak, Ni exercise, Sekejap, saya nak cari ruang kosong sikit. Okay, kita ada surface reaction. Since I cannot write on the board, surface reaction, my handwriting, I'm using mouse, Kalau surface reaction, then you need to design reactor by using KR. Your rate law ni. Rate law tu penting kan? Betul tak? Okay, if it is controlled by internal, if you find out it is controlled by external dulu, external. Then your rate law you need to use KC, KCAAC. Small. Okay, if it is controlled by internal, internal diffusion, then you have to use omega K, Chi equals to KR. KR any omega. If it is controlled by external plus internal, then you have to use omega KR. Apa sini okay tak?
if your process is controlled by surface, then your rate law, kan, your rate law is like RA negative, kan, equals to K something, betul tak? CA for example. So your K ni, yeah, your K ni. So if your surface, if it is controlled by surface reaction, then your K is your KR. Yeah, rate law is K, yeah. If it is controlled by external, your K will be your KCA AC. And because your KC will be meter per second, kan? Then you have to multiply with AC, then you get per second. If it is controlled by internal, then your effectiveness factor equals to KR. If it is controlled by external and internal, then omega equals to KR. So the problem is, what is omega, kan? Tadi, we already told you, you need to get your Taylor modulus. From Taylor modulus, you will calculate your effectiveness factor. So from effectiveness factor, you can calculate your omega. So how to get your omega? This is falsified, yeah? So omega ni, where to get this omega? Okay, look at page in your book, yeah? Yeah, I cari yang the best omega, yeah? Okay, turn to page 8388. Turn to page 838. Kita jumble up sikit, eh? 838. To ensure that you're okay. Turn to page 838. So we got this equation, 1255. Stack that page. This is only first order, eh? Overall effectiveness factor. Eh? Overall effectiveness factor. Okay, this equation. Omega. Eh? Tadi, you got Taylor modulus. And then, you will get your effectiveness factor. After that, then you will get your Taylor omega. Eh? Overall effectiveness factor. Okay, from this, you calculate your... You calculate your omega effectiveness factor here, and then you calculate this one. One, this is our effectiveness factor K double prime S A rho B divided by K C A A C. Nampak tak? This one omega only controlled by, it is controlled by both internal and external. Means that both internal and external control the reaction. So you can use this omega. However, if it is controlled by effectiveness factor, this is dimensionless, dimensionless, must be dimensionless. If it is controlled by internal diffusion, eh, then your omega equals to your effectiveness factor. If it is controlled by internal diffusion, eh, internal only. Why we say like that? Because let's say this is your equation. Eh, omega equals to effectiveness factor divided by 1 plus blah blah blah. Means your KC is very big when it is controlled by internal diffusion, kan? Your KC will be very big. Something divided by very big, this one will become zero. So omega must be equals to this effectiveness factor. This is only applied if it is controlled by internal diffusion. Strongly controlled by internal diffusion. Clear, eh? Clear tak? Omega equals to effectiveness factor if it is controlled by internal diffusion. Okay? Means because your KC is very big. Something that divided to very big. So, it will become Z, zero. Yeah. Yeah? Sampai sini clear, eh? Sampai sini okay tak? Clear tak?
Clear, doctor. Clear.
Ah, clear. So you can identify which one, eh? So the equation very important. So tag that page, yeah? Tag that page. Yeah? 1255 ni tag that page. So daripada situ, then barulah you boleh kira you punya catalyst tu. Reactor size. Faham? Kira yang tu dulu. Yeah? Verify yang tu dulu. Eh? Saya simplifikan chapter 3 ni, dia banyak. So the best way is I simplify. Yeah, simplify and you can get it. Benda yang penting sahaja, ya. Yeah? This is your omega, eh? This is your omega, eh? Yang tadi tu, eh? Overall effectiveness factor, eh? This one, omega, this one is external diffusion, external blood, mass transfer, both external control, internal pun control. Then omega equals to this one, eh? Sampai sini okey tak?
Okay,
that's why I letak tadi tu, yang mana tadi? Dah hilang ke tadi, ya? Mass criterion. Dekat question. Dekat exercise ni. Ha, ni ya? That's why kalau surface yang control, so your K equals to KR. If your external yang control, then your K will be KCA, AC. If internal yang control, that is equals to your KR. Eh? Omega ni sama dengan effectiveness vector KR. If it is external and internal, then you have to use omega. Use this one, look at this one, so much easier for you to design. So you need to verify which one control the process, and from that, then you can verify, verify which K to use, and you'll be able to design the reactor. Clear? Clear? Nanti nak design tu sama kan? Okay, good. Nanti nak design tu sama. Sama je. Masih lagi mole balance, after mole balance, rate law, after rate law, stoichiometry, after stoichiometry and combine. Eh? So yang tu you solve. Okay? Boleh ya? Eh? So you masukkan sahaja. Masukkan sahaja balik semula. Design tu sama je. Macam yang design biasa tu. Cuma yang ni je lah, cuma you kena tahu KR mana, rate law mana yang pakai. K mana yang you nak pakai, which K that you need to use. Boleh eh? You nak buat exercise ke ataupun you boleh, kalau I bagi then buat benda ni sebagai homework, boleh ke? Bukan homework lah, exercise lah, up to you lah, I cannot check. So if you want to know more then you have to do on your own lah kan. I can tolong je, I can help you.
Boleh,
Doktor. Okay, if that is the case, look at example yang tadi tu, yang kita buat. We have done this example, 12-14. Look at example 12-14. Yeah? 12-14. Okay, 12-14, example 12-14. Yeah, we got the same book, yeah? We got the same book, yeah? Kenapa dah ni? 8.45. Boleh, terlebih. Okay. This is the example that in your book, eh? Example in your book. So they give you K double prime, KCAPC ni semua, yeah? Dia masukkan, yeah? Look at here. So the first thing is they need to verify either surface reaction or desorption, eh? So from that, this is yang mole balance biasa, eh? Ni mole balance biasa. Macam mana nak dapat, I already told you kan. Yeah? Macam mana nak dapat, this is mole balance biasa. Ini yang, ini first order ni, yeah? CA. Yeah? First order. So daripada sini, dia convert jadi sini. Yeah? Ni guna molar flux. Yeah? Molar flux. So you dapat this one. Yeah? This only can apply kalau the first order. Yeah? First order. Kalau F tak boleh pakai. Okay, then this one, then to calculate, to verify which one control the reaction. Eh? Sebab dia ada omega kat sini. Kita tak tahu siapa yang control. So in this case, bila dia verify, so dia dapat this one large, kan? Large. Eh? So omega dia large. So dia verify, CWP dia berapa? Lebih daripada satu, kan? Ke kecil daripada satu? Saya tak ingatlah. Kecil kan? Eh? What's the CWP? Berapa CWP dah?
kecil bersatu kan? You guys? So kecil bersatu ke besar bersatu? Besar bersatu kan? Bapak sudah
besar bersatu kan? Ada.
Ha?
Besar bersatu.
Besar bersatu kan? Ha, besar bersatu. So besar bersatu means it is mass transfer, betul tak?
Yes.
Kan? Ada mass transfer. Hmm. Lepas tu dia verify mass, of course internal ada. Faham tak? Internal ada kan? Bila besar bersatu internal confirm. Ya kan? And then dia calculate pula external ni, dia nak kira mass criterion pula. Sebab dia tak nak kira, in order for you to kira mass criterion, dia kena kira, kena dapatkan KC. So dia kira nak dapat ni, dia kira KC. Lepas tu dia kira mass criterion pun dia dah boleh dapat. Maybe dia punya mass criterion tu should be bigger than 0.115. Means that it is internal dengan X, external. So bila lebih macam tu, so dia nak kena kira omega. That's why in this case, they calculate the omega here because both the diffusion control, both the diffusion control kat sini. That's why they kira omega. So bila kira omega, nampak tak? Then they kata, we see that both internal and external resistance to the transfer are significant. Nampak? Bila dah ada omega ni, bila dia design, omega ni 0.58. Nampak tak? Design kat sini, dia masukkan omega ni dalam sini. Sebab dia internal and external control. Faham? Ni kalau internal both, kalau ni both internal, kalau external sahaja then dia kena guna KCAC, kalau dia internal then dia akan, you akan dapat effectiveness factor terus kali dengan K value, KR KR. Kalau dia kalau dia both internal campur external sekali, then you have to use omega K R. Kalau dia surface reaction, ini ingat supaya you tak ni So you have to use K R alone. Okay, this is very important. Okay guys, boleh Ada kat buku tu tepi tu. So not much easier for you to remember that. This is the rules ya. Okay. Boleh So yang lain tu you can design as it is. Bila you nak design, bila yang ni, bila kena omega, dia guna rho b. Nampak ni rho b. Dia ada different rho b dengan rho c. What's the difference of rho b and rho c? So look at page, okay ni rho b. Okay look at page ni sebelum ni. Typekan that page nanti saya tunjukkan page tu. Ini rho b. Rho b equals to rho c satu tolak void, porosity. Okay, so this is rho b. Kalau design, kalau omega guna rho b. Okay. Clear? Boleh? Kalau boleh, then you may do your exercise in your book. There's a lot of exercise. In your book, there's a lot of exercise, Okay, look at your exercise ni. Ya, you boleh buatlah exercise in your kalam. In your kalam. You can do the exercise. Means that we have covered chapter 2 and chapter 3. So in chapter 3, I do not concentrate on how to design the reactor. Pasal nak design the reactor macam biasa. Mole balance, Mole balance. After mole balance, rate, law,
Ikut je. Sama je. After Red Law and then stoichiometry. After stoichio, then combine. Yeah. Do not solve eh. When I mark, I still find some of the students solve it. Then solve lah terus. Beri tu dia. And do not solve. You solve lah. That's it lah. Then combine, baru you solve. Yeah. Okay. Habislah chapter 3. In 1 hour. Okay tak?
Okay, doctor. Okay, doctor.
Clear, eh? So clear, if that is clear for you, so I'm happy with that, yeah? If it is clear, then I'm happy with that. So, any question? So, I advise you to do the exercise, eh? The exercise that we provide in Kalam. Try to do it. And we can discuss in our WhatsApp group. Jangan lupa. So, this WhatsApp group. And I saw the other group, they share a lot of information in the WhatsApp group. So, our WhatsApp group is so quiet. So, try to do it. So, we help each other. We help each other. I cannot help. I only can help you if you help yourself. If you do not have anything, so we might end our class earlier. Not earlier lah. We can, Kalau tak ada, any question? Okay, if there's not any question, before we wrap up, we need to, I want you to revise back what you have learned. Okay, what did you learn today? What do you learn? Sorry, what do you learn today? Okay. What do you learn today? Anyone? Taylor modulus, good. Okay, what else? You can chat. If you don't want to speak, you can chat. Mias, good. Calculate effectiveness factor, good. Okay, what else you've learned?
Okay, good. We also learned how to verify the yang surface area, yes or no, internal, and how, what is the controlled by surface area or controlled by external or controlled by internal, and what the rate that we use to for every control. For example, okay. For surface area, control rate low ialah KR, external KCAC, external plus internal KR plus omega, KR omega. And lastly, for internal effectiveness, KR.
Because your omega is you still do your omega, but because it is controlled by internal, your omega is equals to your effectiveness factor. Good, well done. So I hope everyone will get the same thing. The same thing. Please do the exercise. And then if not, okay. Next week, okay. Done.